हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस वीडियो वी विल सॉल्व द न्यूमेरिकल्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोकेमिस्ट्री एंड आई हैव टेकन क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम द टेक्स्ट बुक एंड दीज आर द अनसॉल्व्ड क्वेश्चन ऑफ योर टेक्स्ट बुक. ओके, नाउ हियर इज वन क्वेश्चन. हाउ मेनी इलेक्ट्रॉन्स वुड हैव अ टोटल चार्ज ऑफ 1 कूलम. नाउ दे आर आस्किंग हाउ मेनी इलेक्ट्रॉन्स ओके will be carrying a charge of 1 coulomb. It means the question is 1 coulomb charge, 1 coulomb of charge would be carried by how many electrons. Okay, now in order to solve this we should have our basics clear with us, and our basics are that we know very well 1.602 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb charge is carried by one electron. Okay, by one electron. So now it becomes easy that 1 coulomb charge would be carried by how many electrons. We'll have to just cross multiply 1 into 1. Okay, we'll write 1 into 1 upon this value. We have to write 1.602 into 10 raised to minus 19. Okay, now when you solve this, okay, you have to solve using logarithm or using your tables. I am directly writing the answer that you will be getting 6.242 into 10 raised to 18 electrons. Okay, so the solution of this numerical is that 1 coulomb charge would be carried by 6.242 into 10 raised to 18 electrons. Fine, so this was the first numerical, and now we move on to next numerical. Next numerical, if you see, it is written here that what current strength in amperes. Okay, means they are asking what is the value of I. Okay, what is the value of I? So what current strength in ampere will be required to produce 2.4 gram of copper. So 2.4 gram of copper means mass of copper is given, which is 2.4 gram from copper sulfate solution in 1 hour. Now 1 hour is the time which is given, so we convert this 1 hour into the seconds. So 1 hour is having 60 minutes. 60 minutes, if you convert it to seconds, you'll be getting 3600 seconds. Okay, now the question is find out the current strength. Okay, we know the formula very well. We have solved this numerical during our theory sessions also. So let us try to solve this. So mass of copper would be is equal to IT upon F into mole ratio multiply by molar mass. Fine. Now for the mole ratio, we know very well that we should have the half cell reaction with us for the particular element. So mole ratio, if we calculate, it is the number of moles of product formed upon electrons required for it. So in this example, the mole ratio is 1/2. Okay, so I substitute the values over here and I write I is equal to, okay, I is equal to mass of copper. Now mass of copper in this example we are having, the value is given, it is 2.4, okay, multiply by F. F is 96500. Okay, now this T will come down, so time is 3600 into, now mole ratio is half, so the 2 will go as numerator and molar mass is 63.5. okay, now so when you solve this, okay, you have to solve it using your logarithm or your tables, you'll be getting answer as 2.03. you'll be getting the current which is passing, okay, 2.03 amperes. Okay, so we have solved the second numerical also. Now children, we are having next numerical and the question is formulate cell. Okay, formulate cell. Now to formulate cell, we have to remember one trick which I have shared with you, and that trick is LOAN, LOAN, RRCP. Okay, this is left hand side, this is oxidation, this is anode, this is negative electrode, this is right hand side, this is reduction, this is cathode, and this is positive charge. Okay, now let us apply this in this particular, so let us apply this particular trick to the above question. Okay, now just look at the first reaction. It is Au plus 3 gaining 3 electrons. This is reduction reaction. Okay, whereas the second reaction is oxidation. Now if oxidation is taking place, just see here, if oxidation is taking place, it means it is anode, it is negative charge, it will be represented on the left hand side. Okay, so I write here anode over here would be magnesium and cathode over here would be gold. Okay, so we apply the trick over here and we try to frame the cell now. Okay, I begin with the left hand side. Fine, left hand side, oxidation taking place, anode is negatively charged, so I put here negative and I write here magnesium, okay, which is having solid state, it is dipped in its own ions children, and it is aqueous. Okay, now this is the representation of left hand side. Now I discuss the right hand side. Right side, reduction taking place. Yes, here is reduction taking place, so it will be cathode and it will be positively charged. So I'll write here positive, and now I'm going to write Au solid, which is dipped in Au, its own ions, and it is aqueous. Okay, now we have to represent over here the salt bridge also. So electrons are moving from positive electrode to negative electrode, and in this way the current is flowing. Electron is moving from magnesium to Au, and this is the flow of current. Okay, so we have formulated the cell. Now students, our next question is what is the cell potential, what is the standard cell potential. Standard cell potential means E0 cell, they are asking E0 cell, and data is given, there is one reaction they have given, and this data is also given, SRP value of the electrodes. Now the formula for E0 cell is E0 of cathode minus E0 of anode. Okay, we have to look at the values now. Who is acting as cathode? Cathode would be the element which is present above, okay, or cathode is the element which is having high SRP value, and anode will be the element which is having low SRP value. I write here high SRP value. Okay, now if you compare with this particular higher SRP value, so minus 0.25 will come first because nickel is acting as cathode, and minus, I have written minus, and minus 1.66. okay, so minus 0.25 plus 1.66. fine, So when you solve this particular example, you will be getting answer as plus 1.41 volt. Okay, so standard cell potential is plus 1.41 volt. Children, here we move on to the next question, construct galvanic cell. Now when they say construct galvanic cell, we have already done one numerical based on it. They want us to identify the anode, identify the cathode. Okay, so we have to identify anode, okay, and we have to identify cathode. Now who is acting as anode, which is having lower SRP value? Okay, and who is acting as cathode, which is having higher SRP value? Okay, lower SRP value means negative SRP value. So if in that case our anode is going to be manganese and cathode is going to be cobalt. Okay, now it becomes easy to write the cell, to construct the cell. Okay, so I remember the same trick we have to apply over here. Okay, left hand side oxidation will take place. Oxidation is anode. So in this case, this is our anode. So I will write Mn, which is solid, dipped in the solution of its own ions. Okay, and this is aqueous, and here I write cobalt, which is solid, dipped in the solution of its own ion, and it is aqueous, and there is a salt bridge. Okay, this is negative charge, this is positive charge, this is the flow of electron, and this is the flow of electric current. So this is the answer to the particular question, that is galvanic cell. Okay, now we will solve this, calculate E naught cell. We all know the formula of E naught cell is E naught of cathode minus E naught of anode. Now cathode in this case is our cobalt. Okay, so I write here CO, that is our cathode, CO3CO, and our anode is Mn plus 2Mn. Okay, when we solve this, we will be getting answer as 1.82 minus 1.18. I have taken values from here. Okay, so when we solve this, we will be getting answer as 3.00 volt. Okay, now suppose if they are asking one more question over here, and the question is you have to write the cell reactions also. Okay, cell reactions also if you have to write, then what we will do, then we will be writing your first reaction at anode. Okay, reaction at anode would be, this is anode, Mn is anode, so I write here Mn solid is losing how many electrons? Charge is 2 plus, so it is going to lose 2 electron. Okay, Mn plus 2 aqueous. If charge is plus 2, means 2 electrons have been lost. Okay, so cathode in this case would be now CO3, okay, aqueous. See, it is charge is 3 plus. So it will gain 3 electrons and you will get CO solid. Okay, now we have to write the net cell reaction. But remember, before writing net cell reaction, we have to make number of electrons equal. So we multiply this by 2, we multiply this by 3, and we multiply this by 2. Okay, if we follow this, then the electrons will get cancelled and the final answer would be, it would be, just try to pause the video and see what answer are you getting. Okay, we'll be getting 3 Mn solid plus 2, okay, so it is 3 plus aqueous, and then we'll be getting 3 Mn plus 2 aqueous plus we'll be getting 2CO solid. Okay, so this is the answer for cell reaction. Now here we have the question, calculate EMF of the cell. Okay, calculate EMF of the cell means they are asking calculate what is E cell. Okay, and the formula of E cell is this, we know very well. Fine. Now we should know E naught cell. What is the value of E naught cell? So we'll calculate E naught cell first. Okay, so E naught cell, as we have discussed earlier also, it is E naught of cathode minus E naught of anode. Now cathode, in this case it is written, it is on the right hand side chromium, so I'll write directly, it is chromium and it is zinc. So I write here that chromium is having the value of -0.74 - -0.76. okay, so when we solve this, we'll be getting answer as 0.02 volt. Okay, so E naught cell value we have got. Fine. Now this E naught cell value I will substitute over here, but we should also know what is number of electrons, and we should also know what is this product and reactant. So to know what is N and what is concentration of product and reactant, we have to write the reaction. Okay, so I write the reaction as follows, that zinc is going to lose 2 electrons, and we will write the physical states also, and chromium plus 3 is going to gain 3 electrons. Okay, and it is going to form Cr solid. But do you remember I told you we have to make number of electrons same, so I multiply this entire by 2, okay, and entire by 3. So I write here 3, 3, 6. Okay, here I write 2, 6, 2. Now students, number of electrons are same and it is 6. It means our N is going to be 6. And the reaction is 3Zn solid plus 2 chromium aqueous, then 3Zn aqueous, okay, plus 2Cr solid. Fine. Now we are going to write down the expression for E cell. E cell is equal to E naught cell, directly I'll put the value 0.02 minus 0.0592 upon N. And what is our N? N is 6. So I write here 6. And now I have to write down the concentration of product. Remember, concentration of the product, if it is solid, then it is written 1. Okay. Now, here we have aqueous. Products are these. So I'll write here concentration of zinc raised to, this coefficient is written as superscript. Okay, and solid is not considered. Okay, then upon, I'll come to reactant side, with formula is reactant. So in the reactant, solid we will not write, and we have chromium concentration raised to 2. So don't forget that here we are having 3 and here we are having 2. Okay, now we have to solve this, and let us begin to solve this particular expression. Okay, so we have got E cell is equal to 0.02 minus 0.0592 upon 6, okay, and log of, now see here it is zinc concentration raised to 3. Now concentration of zinc, if you see, it is 0.08 cube, and concentration of chromium is 0.1 square. Okay, so when you are going to solve this, you will be getting 0.02 minus, so when you solve this entire expression, you have to solve and just check out that are you getting this okay, and the final answer of this would be 0.0327 volt. Okay, now here we have another numerical based on the concept, calculate E cell. Now already we know that E cell formula is E cell is equal to E naught cell minus 0.0592 upon n log of product upon reactant. So children, first we will identify which is anode and which is cathode. Okay, now just have a look at this particular expression which is given, the cell which is given. Hydrogen is present towards the right side. Okay, so we know that here it is a cathode and here it is anode. Fine. Concentration of zinc is given 0.2 molar. Concentration of H plus is given 1.6 molar. Okay. Now, partial pressure of the hydrogen is given 1.8 atmosphere. Fine. So, I calculate first E naught cell, E of cathode minus E of anode. Cathode is our hydrogen. So, I have already written hydrogen minus E naught of zinc. I have already written zinc. The potential, the SRP of hydrogen is 0. So, I wrote 0 minus bracket minus 0.763. So, the answer for this, you know, it is 0.763 volt is our E naught cell. Okay. Now, in order to know what is, so this value we know, in order to know what is N, we should know the chemical reaction. Here I have written the chemical reaction for your simplicity, that zinc undergoing oxidation and H ion undergoing reduction. Okay, now, so when you cancel these two electrons, you would be getting zinc, you would be getting zinc as solid plus 2H plus as aqueous, and then you would be getting Zn plus 2 aqueous and plus H2 as hydrogen gas. Okay, so when we solve this much, you will come across this equation. So now we'll try to write this 0.763 minus 0.0592 upon 2, because number of electrons are 2 over here, and now I write log of, see, I will use this expression, I'll use this equation to solve. Fine. So I have concentration of zinc, okay, and I have partial pressure of hydrogen upon concentration of H plus square. Okay, here I'm going to substitute the values now, and then let us see what answer are we getting. Okay, so I begin over here. I'll continue to write 0.763 minus 0.0 is 296 log of, now concentration of zinc ions, it's given concentration is 0.2 and partial pressure is 1.8 on, now concentration of H plus, look here, 1.6 square. Okay, so when you solve this entire expression, you would be getting 0.763 minus, so when you are going to solve this entire expression, you will be getting this answer. While calculation, you would be getting plus over here, 0.0252. Okay, and then finally the answer is going to be 0.7882 volt. So children, you will have to solve this particular expression and just check how you're getting this plus over here. Okay, now here we have one more numerical based on equilibrium constant concept. Okay, see, the equilibrium constant of the reaction is given. It means this is the value of K. And what is the standard cell potential? Whenever the term is standard, you have to remember it is not E naught cell. So the formula is E cell is equal to E naught cell minus 0.0592 upon n log of product upon reactant is being replaced by equilibrium constant. Okay, now during equilibrium, see they are talking about equilibrium. So during equilibrium, the value of E cell is 0. Value of E cell is 0. Hence, you are shifting this E naught cell towards left hand side. So you'll be getting 0.0592 upon. Okay, now N over here, just see how much is the increase in the number of electrons. There's only 1. So I'll write 1. And log of value of K I will write. Okay. The value of K is 1.2 into 10 raised to 6. Okay. So, as you solve this, you will be getting answer as 0.0592. Now, log of 1.2 is log of 1.2 into 10 raised to 6. You will be getting it as 6.079. Okay, so when you solve this, you will be getting answer as 0.36 volt. Okay, so what we have calculated, E naught cell. Okay, I hope the numericals which I have discussed with you, you have understood this. You can pause the video and you can again check out the explanation of the numerical. After watching this video, it is a request that all of you write or solve these numericals on your own in your notebooks, and you can submit to me in the form of assignment.